I'm very excited about your talk, about your plans to build an industrial park here in Bayelsa. And for me, and that's why I keep talking about partnerships and collaborating, need for us to collaborate. And I see an excellent opportunity for partnership in that regard. I don't see why we shouldn't collaborate and make this one happen, for example. Instead of pursuing through industrial development, through industrial parks, you know, parallel developing at the same time. So I want to know, I know your executive secretary is not around, but I don't know if you have some knowledge about policies in that regard that you can answer. Because I want to direct my team to collaborate with you. And if it means that I take it up with His Excellency the Vice President and whoever at the federal level, I think there is need in collaborating so that we make one happen. In which case, you can take some of the facilities right there now. As I said earlier, Shell already has a $4 billion facility there. You already have an NIPP project there. So if you may have issues of land and then preparation of land and other things, compensation, clearing and all of that to deal with. But if we were to work on this, we have already acquired, compensation paid, and the land is set. We're ready to go. So I want to know if you can give any indication as to possibilities for partnership. So this can start, by the way.
If you recall, the Premier Executive Secretary had discussions with you. I remember one time we came to your office and we both realized we were on the same page on oil and industrial parks. While ours is more specific to oil and gas, yours is of a more general nature, and I can see where we will find synergy. I'm not going to stand here and make a policy decision. I don't have the powers of His Excellency here. But it's a clear message. And in fact, I thought when I saw your model and the presentations, and there was no mention of NCDMB, I was a bit surprised. But I did see it finally, so I thought there was some reference to us. Thank you, Excellency. We're going to work with you.
Thank you, Dr. Tabjok's views. The key pillar of the NCD, Global Content Policy of Nigeria, is to build capacity. We're talking only about capacity of infrastructure, we're talking about human capacity as well. If you don't have the people with the requisite skills to drive the infrastructure, you only have people that are like amateurs. So it's ever so important that you develop people who drive this industrial power we're talking about. What we have done in our experience over the years is to consciously give scholarships to our host communities. Every year we give 200% scholarships to go and begin to learn skills that will drive this process. Time will come when I will exit. There are people who should continue doing the work. And during the last year, we went a step further and developed what we call a graduate program. We hired 50 graduates from the host communities to teach them what we do. What we do in our facilities are not like primarily the universities. Logistics, we account for 10% of the spend to produce a barrel of oil. So if it's well done, you achieve a good mileage in the oil and gas industry. So we employ 50 graduates, train them in what we do. They went through all the facets of our company and they learned what we do. Thereafter, they were put to different sessions. From here, we put them to different areas where they work. So I think it's ever so important that the companies will begin to partner with the communities where they work to develop people who take the facets of the business. And I'm so much encouraged by the plan of the state government to develop this park, as well as education. I'm told that the government is doing a great deal in the area of education this journey went to achieve this grandiose animation we saw. If you don't have the people, they won't work. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chibwisi. And yet, we came there.
About the importance of this forum. I've had discussions with the Commissioner of Trade. Excellent guy, Kemela. But I'm just interested in why the Bayelsa government is somehow ahead of their counterparts, a lot of their counterparts in this country. Because what we've seen is that it's only now that some governors are waking up to realize that, look, if oil prices fall, they can pay salaries. And here we are, you know, sitting in the second segment of a forum that already envisages that the future is upon us. The future itself is upon us. And so time will come when salaries will no longer be paid simply because oil prices are volatile in international.